So we got I lag today. It doesn't have any. Actually, no. Its fundamentals aren't bad. It's an IPO. It ran recently. It has cash. It doesn't have any dilution. So we're gonna see. Hopefully, it goes to 4. This area here. See how there's this many wicks. I have a good feeling it's gonna extend to here. I don't know if it's gonna fail here, but we'll see how the tape is. Hi, Mark.
Hey, dude.
How are you?
Not much. What are your plans, bro? What are you looking at?
I'm looking at iLag. It's a runner, like previous runner. So I'd like it to extend more, but I have a shelf in the pre-market. I'm going to see how it's going to react there. There's also APRN. Just going to see what it's going to do. Hopefully it goes for like above the pre-market high. Like yeah. I'll only touch it there and see how it acts.
Now that I'm looking at it, I just said it on the chat, but tends to have, yeah, it looks like it's annoying. Let me look at the stats on that. $5 million float, and that's it. They don't really have any. Oh, is this Apex? That's why. Oh, well, I'll just keep watch of it. I don't know how strong yesterday ended for you guys, but oh sure, it's last minute. Alright, good luck guys. I'll just ask you a question later.
Okay. Anyway, it's gonna open now. Let's see
what. No news on iLag too.
iLag is probably gonna be really annoying.
Traps. No fundamentals. Rough. All right, good luck, guys.
Market is open.
Looking for APRN for a potential long.
Oh, it's coming up.
It did dip there.
350. I see a lot of bids. Yeah.
Pretty sure. I feel like APRN's gonna end green today. So. Here's some AA orders on APRN. Oh, sweet. I like it.
Yeah, it is. 345. Okay. The Let's just watch the tape. So yeah, it's green so far. It's gonna test 360.
Ooh, JLAN rejection on APRN.
Bruh. It might be one of those. Okay, I see what you're doing. Wow, that is really annoying.
Holding that 660s. Let's see. Let go, bro. Then we clamped right after again. Every time it breaks that 660s, it big buy, back it up. Actually, let me change that. This is $6. Crap, I forgot to adjust my bids. Central condition. Okay. Okay, buying back up 6 APRN. Offer trap there. Let's see. $0.02 spread. This does look weak, but we'll see. Off of bid prop there, 650 something. Okay, some good buyers here at the 660s, but not much movement above. Cool. Okay. Let's see. Needs to break that 670 with volume. One day. You got the JLR. There it is. Okay, I'm like balancing the 1000 anyway, so let me see. Six-37 off a trap. You in anything, guys? I don't really see the typical setup we go for.
No.
Or at least I go for.
I missed I lag.
I lag? What are we trying to get?
I thought it would go higher, but I wasn't looking at the tape correctly.
Yeah, the first candle was only like 400 to 300, 400,000.
Yeah, that would have been a good pop and fail. But it had no like dilution and it was like a previous runner, so I was like, oh yeah, this should go like for $4 or something.
It's still good. I mean, it's early enough in the day that it
Yeah.
could turn around.
It might be one of those where it starts kind of weak and then picks up through consolidation.
Maybe. Anytime I try to look for longs, I read the tape badly. Up, Flo? Good trade, bro.
Hey guys.
How are you, man?
Good. I don't know. I missed a bunch of entries. But
You're
now
the
I
only
have
one
a.
that traded so far. Good job.
That was, yeah. The same like yesterday. Yesterday I had only a pre-market trade as well.
Yeah. I'm still long biased on APRN. But.
Yeah, so you have different stats than OTC.
Oh, does he think I'll be a fader?
He said he predicted it pretty much to his a 226 high probability of fade at the open since it pushed. Stats don't lie.
Okay. Yeah, no, I don't have any stats against OTC here. I was just basing it off past stats, or not the edge to trade gapper stats, and it's been a stronger market these days, right? Would you say? You guys are more
Yeah.
aligned with it than I am.
Well, I don't like it. It's
Could you?
day two, so it's actually nothing for me. I just practice these pre-market trades. So this was a 10 share trade.
Oh, you're right. It is day
So
two.
this is just a practice basically.
Yeah.
Okay, run up, yeah. Okay, yeah, I see that point. And ILAC is playing games. Even though on super low volume, so I don't.
Well, it's also just ending going down too. But that one also has two gap stats that show it ending up. So I'm long biased in that too. But maybe everything's just gonna go down today. We'll see. Certainly, if it reclaims that VWAP and holds, I'll start thinking more long biased. But there's like no fundamentals on this. I don't even know what the shares outstanding is. Oh, like 5 million float. So
Yeah,
there you go.
ILEC is at least a recent IPO. I don't exactly know
Oh, is
when
it?
it
Oh,
IPO'd. It's I mean not weeks, but a couple months, I believe. Yeah, I mean so far nothing I like. I don't even like ILEC and APRN. And what's the other one? MRIN,
MRN, yeah, that one's just dying
dying
too.
pre market.
Low volume.
Yeah.
This is usually what I like to see when a stock has low volume. Not that crazy stuff you guys had to go through last week.
Yeah, it's a shame that I've missed the JLine rejection on APRN. It almost happened simultaneously to the ILAC push. Oh, I was looking back and forth, and ended up not trading either one of them. No, it's just funny how how my mind works, because I didn't like APRN, and it's kind of, you know, a more expensive ticker for me, and day two, so I was leaning into ILAG. But then on the other hand, I said, like, dude, focus on the one you're in and not, the, you know, back and forth in my head. And then, like, ooh, that one, missed that one. Oh, let's check out the other one. Ooh, missed that one too. Like, ah, Jesus. But okay, I mean, since we're practicing, you know, entries, and I want my chart to look nice, the APRN kind of looks okay, I guess, even though the...
It's bouncing now, so maybe it'll pick up here. Or maybe OTC is right, and I'll go, keep going now. I trust them more, but...
But it's bouncing at the final target, whatever the yeah. setup is for those day two, but yeah. So I'm not going to touch it anymore.
No. I think this one would be really interesting if it bounces, if it reclaims open. And then the higher day, intraday, 694.
Yeah, I see that, but that's so not my play.
No, yeah, neither do I.
So... what's I like? I mean, I like clear out of the 360 within the next, I don't know, 20-25 minutes. That's something that I would like to see. Everything else, I either don't have locates, or not prepared, or it died already, or it scares me, or any of that. Or all of them. Christian, are you in anything?
No, I didn't get in ILAG. That was the only one that I was looking for. So, I'm not in anything.
Okay. That's probably okay, that's... one of these days. I had the one that we talked about, the limit order. I don't know
yeah.
if you were there, I think Mac. Yeah. The limit order, so the APRN trade was a limit order at 710, and that got filled. And then I had a limit order for ILAG for 356, I believe.
Oh, that would have been 59, good.
59. The high of the
yeah
that didn't get filled, but that's all just super small size because I'm playing with pre-market and with limit orders, so
yeah.
But APRN at least worked
nice.
Yes, today will be a short day if nothing happens in the next hour.
I probably don't even give it an hour.
I don't mind.
Are you back, Mark, or is this a slow transition from holiday to...
Slow transition. I'm still trying to get the account set up, but I do have the montage in the level 2, so even if I wanted a trade, I can't.
Well, so what is it you're setting up? Trade 0, or...?
Yep. I wanna figure some things out. I have some, I can read the tape and all that jazz, but my system trades still need work on. I'm still not like consistent, you know. So I keep losing money because my Sterling account, it charges me like nearly $300 a month. And so if I wanted to like just test using super small size, like 1 shares, I'd still have to use the Sterling account, which will charge me $300. And so I'm like always red every month just on those fees alone. So
yeah.
So you're pausing Sterling and then going to Trade 0?
Yeah, pretty much. Okay. Just so I could back test and my system trades and get it better. And then once I can see like consistency there, I'll switch back again.
Okay, cool. That makes sense. Yeah, I'm curious to see how that works because I was tempting to try, but then another platform and anything that I had to learn it.
Well, don't they have that for DOS or no? Like,
I'm happy. It's just it is. I'm to be honest, I'm super happy. And even locates like today, I got APRN, ILAG.
Yeah, but don't they have paper trades? You did that for
Yeah, they have all that. It's just it's the PD. What's it called? PDT.
PDT.
And the, I mean, I don't know. DOS is, I would say, 150-ish a month. So it's not sterling expensive, but it's not Trade Zero cheap.
Yeah.
And like, of course, I'm trading below that, right? So I'm red on every month as well, just like you.
But just on based off the fees. Yeah, dude. Yeah. Trading is expensive. I'll still be red in a month if I still do paper trades, but at least it'll be like $60 or $100, $118 a month instead of 300 something. So.
Yeah. Are you paying for Ash? Is anyone paying for Ash? Right? Chris Ari is not listening, right?
What? I pay for Ash trade.
Which, plan or
the middle one?
Yeah.
Do you have ExtraTrade still or no? Did that run out for you?
Well, it's running out this week, next week or something. I think this or next week.
Oh dang. We should do that thing, that export thing one more time.
Well, we could do it. Hit me up if you
Don't mind if I do, probably will.
No, and same for Cody Christian or
Thank you. Yeah, I stopped using it. Cause I already pay for Bookmap and that's really expensive.
Yeah, bro. Bookmap is, do you still use Bookmap a lot or do you think it's really worth the money still or
It's kinda weird. I kinda have like, not like a dependency, but it's like, if I don't use it, it feels kind of weird for me. Like, just going off of tape. Because, like, the levels that I can't see on tape, like, they are nice.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. I just think Bookmap is expensive, even though you do a lot of the same things with level 2. Or at least, like, you know, Thinkorswim, you can't... Can you not get the Bookmap on Thinkorswim?
Oh, it's because I have the Russian guy's Thinkorswim, and he doesn't have that.
Okay,
or
that
like
sucks.
It's really
that
hard
way
for him.
Cheaper, man.
Yeah, like $40.
Yeah, that is cheaper. That's true. And what a friend of mine who started small caps and then ditched Bookmap, and because of the costs, and then switched to trading ES only. Now he's back on Bookmap because you get, I think, 5 tickers like Apple, 5 big caps, and ES for free, the data with Bookmap. So, if you want to switch or commit to just trading Apple or so, you know,
save
some money.
But I feel like I shouldn't switch stuff too much.
I'm joking.
Yeah.
Please don't switch just because.
Yeah. Yeah.
Save someone.
Yeah.
Bookmap, it is expensive, but I know exactly how you're feeling, Christian.
Yeah,
so plus I'm the least skilled tape reader of the whole group, so yeah, I'm even further away from getting rid of it, and it just adds. Yeah, I mean, Edge to Trade is another, what is it, 80 or something. We should ask for a group discount
for real.
The JTrader one gives you the most discount, 25%.
I know.
I think that's the most they'll give anyways, and you guys have it. OTCs is 15%, and I know Zach Morris is 15, but Jay's is 25%. So I think that's the most they'll give anyways, so just use that one.
Yeah, that's what I'll do.
So hungry.
expected a bit more action here.
Yeah, same. You know, sometimes like the Gapin crabs, like even though they have really, like they don't have much info, like still, like they just fade really hard. Like
Yeah,
they
with
don't
any
have any
Gapin crab, would you?
dilution. Yeah, like this, I wanted it at like $4.
Wanted 375, but I could live with 360. That's why I had a starter level at 359.
Yeah.
Cody, are you in anything? Nothing, okay. Alec, up to weave up.
Alec is holding. That 3 minute J line's like four times.
True.
VWAP, if it breaks VWAP, I think it'll do really well.
Look at the volume, like, I think this is just people covering here.
Honestly, true. That's why I need like some huge volume spurge spike.
Look at that offer at 340. It was 140. I'd take a mental short here, 37, risking 42. But it's not enough room anyway, so.
Thank you. Okay, Alag. Alags and J-Lines, let's see.
Offer yeah, if they find volume, they can blow up pre-market high in one or two candles.
5 million float too. Yeah, I can see that. 340 offer trap.
That's scary here. Yeah.
Ooh, they pulled it. They pulled that offer trap.
375. I'm interested.
No real selling. Looks like they're holding that 340s. Okay, let's see.
Here, Cody, at 34. Okay.
Ooh, okay, yeah. Some falling here at 340s.
Good job, Cody.
340, bid prop, building up, refreshing.
24 cents is a tight stop for you? Okay. I'm cheap. But yeah, that's a nice wash.
Yeah. Let's go, 340.
That's true, but yeah, maybe you're right. Not the...
Okay, VWAP curl, or not VWAP curl, J-line curl here probably. Offer trap, 345. No big buyers, come on. Went down. Okay, some buyers here.
Yeah, 46.
Okay, offer trap again, 345. Yes, yes, there's the push. Some buyers here have come. There's a lot of buyers there. Let's go. Well, that 345 now hold. Let's see. Looks like a stop a little bit.
Das is not responding.
Ooh, it was a stop. Did you see that? Blow the ILAG VWAP stop.
Yeah, the 350.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They had that offer trap at 345, then they used it, had some big green orders, and then just couldn't continue to push. Bam. Okay, I'll be back getting some water. Good job, Cody, on your APRN.
Yeah, that's pretty good. I mean, shorting it at the 200, but good read, yeah. I like it. So if you're 30 cents in the money, would you really let yourself get stopped out at the original stop? I mean, this is 1 hour or yeah, let's call it 1 hour. Yeah, okay. I for sure would. I wouldn't. I mean, now I probably wouldn't have, like, what, I have 565 as a target, but that's about it. So I don't really, maybe $6, you know, maybe cover some here. I don't know what to do. Like, yeah, okay. Yeah, good. I can see that, yeah.
Yeah, there's a Vivant Boulevard there at 590-ish.
645, Cody, is a volume level. The pink purple one at APRN. I and the O is pushing in case someone wants to get crazy here.
What's that?
I and the O.
And O. Ooh. What's going on with that one? I know what ticker. Oh, dang.
Yeah, be careful.
Jeez.
What?
You know, I was watching Indo, like, earlier, and I thought it was weight, like, it wasn't up enough. Like, it was only up 20%, and I was right. And now it's, like, up, like, 40, 50.
Yeah. I have a level at 12, 14. I don't know what that's from. It's already there, but I'll just aim for that.
Yeah, I'm a lot more patient now on these. To realize how, like, erratic they are.
Yeah, just wait for a shelf. Then see if you can play that. But if you can't.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, dang, the deity level's funky. Honestly, yeah.
He doesn't really respect any of them.
Anyone watching ear?
something going on there too?
I don't know. I'm just browsing through what's on my.
Oh, that's been going up. That's been extending as well.
It's SSR.
I think that one can get interesting if it gets back to $3.
That's true, Cody. Yeah. I mean, they look crazy, but like ear is up 23%. So even though
looks
like. So everything, yeah, Cody just put it perfectly. Everything up, only a very lame amount. So I honestly, it's 10:15. I think that's it for me.
How come you covered all of APRN? Is it because it hit the 1,000 or?
No, because it had 10 shares originally.
Oh.
I ran out of shares. This was a practice pre-market entry practice trade.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, you got into the pre-market.
Yeah.
Mark, there's a...
Today only pre-market trades for me.
Okay, gotcha.
There's a shelf tomorrow right now on Indo.
I have the kids tomorrow on Thursday, so you know, maybe a pre-market trade, but not at the open.
Yeah. Okay.
I'll be back on Friday.
Gotcha, bro.
Yeah. Stay safe.
Alright, bye, Flo.
Alright, see you guys. Bye bye.
Yeah, there's a shelf there.
Not gonna lie, I should have shorted it.
Well, you can't always just short every shelf, but let's see.
Yeah.
Kind of missed that. I wasn't even looking until you said it. Christian, the shelf, and then kind of dumping already.
Well, I mean, it could.
Maybe hold that 9 though.
Yeah.
Just watching it, just to watch it. Not really gonna play it, obviously, because they can't, but. Still looking. There's some buyers there. Looks like they might hold at 9. Yeah, they want to hold that 9. A little bit of a spread too. Yeah, there's definitely a spread. And volume divergence too. This might be the lower high. So, we'll float on this, Christian, do you know?
Let me check real quick. It says 3.8 million.
Yeah,
on sure. Dilution okay. Tracker.
That's.
But it has a bunch of dilution. Like there's a shelf. There's an ATM.
Yeah.
There's convertible notes. There's warrants.
I feel like if it can break that 1120 2 area. I might push back up, but let's see here. Ooh, weak. Unless this is a short trap. Yeah, it just looks weak. Excuse me. Ooh, okay. Let's see. If we can, again, break that 1120s, it's gonna make a new high. Some A orders here. Okay. Trying to keep that price up. Ready though, and so it's just hard to play. Okay, try and go for that 20s again. Oh, there it is. Let's see. Boom. Kind of holding that 20s now. Still a spread, so could still fall. Hey, this was yeah, whoops, guess that was just the stuff.
Dang.
I needed to hold that 1120s if it was gonna break out successfully. That was a good place to aim for if you were thinking another way.
Yeah.
You still interested in anything, Christian? Or I know Cody's probably just an APR and calling it there.
It's kind of at like It's kind of weird to explain. It's like when you said it needed to hold 1120 to break out, I was kind of in between, like, should I long it or should I short it at that point?
Yeah. Again, it's all, remember, it's like not with the offer traps or
Yeah.
like specific levels. If it breaks through, what needs to happen is they need to find the bids to pull, make sure that it doesn't fall below.
Yeah.
This one just didn't have any bids to follow through, so. But yeah, boredom trades for sure. These are honestly, even if I was trying to trade for real, I would not be trading any of this, so. Good discipline, Cody, as always. The only time you lack discipline is when you're outside of the computer. Just kidding, with BWV. If today is like a change in market behavior, I definitely missed all that hard stuff you guys went through. I'm not complaining, but super weak today. Yeah.